Why are alloys so efficient? Perhaps because fusion allowed us to combine properties that don't exist in nature. That's why we have durable, strong, and lightweight materials to build planes, structures, tools, or everlasting dental fillings. In software development, DevOps is much like an alloy, fusing devs and ops to create a unique team. So, the two are working in sync, giving businesses unique properties. Hello, my name is Igor Pavlenko. I'm a quality assurance competence leader at Altexsoft. In the previous video, I explained the peculiarities of the development stage in DevOps. Today, we look at the operation stage of enormous importance as we focus on continuous delivery of our product. So, let's get started. Imagine there is a production-ready application. Bravo to our engineering and testing teams. The job is done and we are ready to deploy. Here the operation stage starts. IT operations cover numerous tasks, but the final purpose is to create an environment on a server where an application can be deployed and run. So let's look at these tasks first, and further I'll explain how things are done in DevOps. First, we obviously need a server where the application will be deployed. Admins will be in charge of buying hardware or setting up a cloud server, installing operating systems, and configuring it for the future deployment. Then, we also must provide security. Administration runs additional tests and finds backdoors to protect your digital assets from hacker attacks, unauthorized or malicious actions. There are various types of security to mention here, like network, internet, cloud, or application security. Deploying the code on the production server is a lot of hassle. Here, we would decide how to deploy the build, which changes are required outside of the build, and which KPIs to track. The final step is monitoring both the application and infrastructure health. We track response time, CPU usage, or error rate, all showing how the application performs. Secondly, the operation team maintains the existing infrastructure. This includes troubleshooting or avoiding downtimes, planning for disaster recovery, creating backups, and so on. These measures are meant to provide developers with a reliable environment to deploy the code as fast as possible. However, there are certain challenges operations face. First of all, operations processes are manual, for the most part. Every time there is a need for a new server or a change in configuration, admins would manually perform the task, delaying the release. Each release traditionally needs to be approved by an operations team, which is also done manually. So, checking the build, preparing the system, and final approval can interfere with the deployment. The requirements for the configuration are also hard to gather, as this knowledge is often locked inside the development team. For the same reason, release planning and preparations also become a problem, as the ops team remains unaware of the development progress. Deployment imposes lots of risks itself. In some cases, deploying the application may crash the server, leading to hour-long downtimes. That's because we usually deploy large application chunks at a time, and the effect on the infrastructure is quite unpredictable. So, how can DevOps help here? The goal of IT operations is to set up an environment that corresponds to development, business, and application requirements, and deploy fast. With DevOps, we expect to deploy daily, rather than every 3 to 5 months. That said, we need to understand that operations should be as fast as the development. But how do we achieve this? In practice, a single team makes things easier. We can make server configuration a shared responsibility between the specific people. Developer A will work in pair up with admin B, eliminating the long-lasting requirement gathering. By removing the silo in communication, ops are able to understand the requirements prior to the release, get more involved in the existing problems, and automate manual things that traditionally were time-consuming. This is done by introducing practices like infrastructure as code, continuous delivery, and continuous monitoring. I'll align these practices with the operation stages. Let's start with infrastructure installation and configuration. DevOps relies on cloud infrastructure by default. Managing physical servers or virtualized ones is too complex when you try to keep up the pace. Cloud infrastructure resolves three main issues. First, cost effectiveness. Buying a physical server is expensive. With cloud infrastructure, we are able to cut costs using only a required part of computing power and memory. Second, scalability. Besides other benefits, the ease of scalability enables a DevOps team to adjust server infrastructure to the application requirements in a few clicks. Third, development friendliness. Needless to say, cloud platforms like Azure or AWS can be instantly scaled, providing self-service tools for developers. This bridges the gap between devs and ops teams, as engineers can easily define system requirements and set these changes by themselves. Besides, DevOps uses such practice as infrastructure as a code. Simply stated, this means managing your server infrastructure using configuration files, text documents that can be copied and shared. These documents apply configuration changes and are tracked through a source control system, like Git. So, as the name suggests, configuration files are treated just like code, allowing us to roll back and configure easier. This also helps avoiding inconsistencies that we usually have with the manual configuration. Moving to security. As the developer triggers the pipeline, a configuration tool can automatically create an infrastructure for the code chunk. The infrastructure in DevOps pipelines can be granular, as it uses isolated instances to deploy and manage code. Further, the system is rapidly changing its state because new code is constantly deployed to the servers. For this reason, we need to emphasize the security issues that may arise in the process. DevSecOps, which stands for Development, Security and Operations, is a dedicated field of operations that ensures security in the DevOps ecosystem. It follows the same logic as the whole continuous delivery process. We apply automated testing in advance to eliminate bugs and security backdoors. At the state of deployment, we apply automated tests to check the configuration and asset state, or investigate threats. For example, we can do runtime security testing, or interactive security testing to find vulnerabilities or network connection errors. Or we can apply static code security testing to check the application source code. And don't forget that operations staff should provide security trainings for developers. What about deployments? Infrastructure as a code is a shared responsibility between devs and ops, which works on the continuous delivery idea. Admins no longer need to gather requirements or apply configurations or approve deploys, as this can be done in pair with developers. On top of that, the process is automated. For example, configuration files can be passed automatically via scripts, while the code itself is automatically deployed via CI/CD tools like Chef or Jenkins. As the code is safe and all the tests are green-lighted, it appears in the production environment. Now we can finally look at how our application performs. So, we are measuring application's health with metrics and KPIs. But since we are deploying frequently, we have to focus on application and infrastructure state. In DevOps, a concept of continuous monitoring means constantly collecting and analyzing the data using specific tools. It's easier to understand with an example. Dedicated interfaces installed on a server automatically track code changes and measure its performance. Results are available on a dashboard, and most of the tools can send alerts to the corresponding team members when something goes wrong. Here, the operation and development teams work together on spotting the cause of an error, rolling back the code update, or switching servers to avoid downtimes or application failure. Under regular conditions, the dashboard provides metrics in the form of statistics so the DevOps team can analyze indicators to receive feedback. The team gets continuous feedback. It helps them proactively address issues in production. That's how the CI/CD pipeline works at the operation stage. Let's briefly summarize the practices. Use cloud infrastructure. Involve developers into configuration management with the help of infrastructure as a code. Remove approval burden by applying continuous delivery. Improve security with DevSecOps automated testing. And finally, implement continuous monitoring to gather metrics and receive continuous feedback. Using these practices, we are able to make operations as agile, as consistent as the development team. But as you can see, it's more about merging the teams by sharing responsibilities and knowledge. Without this, DevOps is just another technological complexity. Keep in mind that the responsibilities of developers don't end at the deployment. This problem is known as the wall of confusion, which I'll elaborate on in the upcoming video. So in the next episode, we are going to discuss the strategic steps to implementing DevOps in your organization. My name is Igor Pavlenko, and see you next time!